Hello everyone, today I am here with a very powerful laser device, Snapmaker Ray. We're starting today's explanation with a small change. As you can see, I will be doing the explanation standing up because, as you can see, this friend here is quite big and blocks my view when I sit down. Therefore, I will conduct the review in this way. Snapmaker is one of the brands that stands out with its material quality and durability in the three-dimensional printers it has made before. Also a brand that loves to offer innovative different solutions, especially dual-head 3D printers that we don't often see in the market, or systems that can easily convert the printer into a laser device or CNC machine in a modular way. While they have already integrated and used diode laser technology into their 3D printers, they recently introduced this monster Snapmaker Ray. It was presented to us by Snapmaker, which is also the sponsor of this video. I have never used a laser device with a power of 40 watts before, so I was excited to see what he could and couldn't do. I have already worked on many materials. I will show you these closely in a moment, but first, let's take a brief look at Ray's features. When you first see this laser device, its simple design and the quality of the materials used impress you. Its very thick aluminum profiles and large laser head make you feel the extreme durability and power of the device. Industrial-grade steel linear rails are used inside these profiles. In this way, the rails are long-lasting and movements can be carried out stably without shaking even in high-speed operations. Snapmaker Ray can engrave or cut on an area of approximately 40 cm by about 60 cm, and during these operations it can reach a speed as high as 500 mm per second. There are 8 diode lasers inside the 40W laser head. These rays are collected at one point with Snapmaker's reflective system, providing a sharp and powerful laser output. The device comes with air assistant as standard equipment. This engine, which provides strong air support, helps prevent possible laser burns during engraving and cutting operations. While the power unit and motherboard of the laser device are located on a separate part, control is provided by a single button on this part. There is no screen on the device. Actually, a screen is not a necessity for Snapmaker Ray, because you can easily make all the controls via its own software, Luban, and thanks to the wireless connection feature, you can seamlessly send the model to the device and then follow the stage of the process. The features of the device are very nice. Now we will also look at how these features work on different materials. I have worked on many materials such as plywood, MDF, fabric, felt, leather, acrylic, and metal. Examine each of them one by one. The first model was a test model available in Snapmaker's software, Luban. It's a square. I cut this again with the plywood from the box. It easily cut this material, 5 mm thick. Only the outer perimeter of this model should be cut. The lines and writings should have been engraved. When I gave them all a single cutting power, the parts inside the numbers were also left blank. This mistake was actually good for the test, because I was able to see that even cuts thinner than a millimeter could be made on this material. A 5mm plywood wouldn't be much of a problem for a 40W laser anyway. This turned out to be a pretty clean cut. On the Snapmaker site, it is stated that the 20W module can cut a 10mm plywood in one pass and this 40W module can even cut a 15 millimeter thick plywood in one pass. In fact, this thickness can even reach up to 2 centimeters on the pine tree. I worked on 6 millimeter MDF, which is harder to cut after 5 millimeter plywood. I cut this model, which has both circular and very sharp patterns on it. The result is very beautiful. Especially at points that are sharp and pointed, there is no deformation on the material. Why do I specifically say this? Because I've used low power laser devices before, and sometimes there could be slight losses in sharpness due to the material burning in these parts. But when combined with a powerful laser speed and also air support, more precise cuts can be made. This piece was a nice example of that.
He exaggerated the cutting process a bit and tried it on a 1.8 meter MDF, but he wasn't very successful.
Even though I went over the same point many times, it could not cut the material properly, and as you can see, MDF started to burn. By the way, we are talking about a laser machine that has security measures against the possibility of fire. If the material you're cutting catches fire, it directly cuts off the laser power and also sounds a loud alarm. The other model is again MDF. I knew it could already cut 3 millimeters of material. I have never made a model that is assembled like this, like a puzzle, before. I definitely wanted to try it and indeed show you this. The cut was very clean and very clear, as expected. If you are interested in such models, there are many paid and free models available on the internet. With these models, you can create fun and exciting projects that both hobbyists and children will love. Maybe you can even make money with projects like this. I also wanted to engrave one on MDF. A power of 40 watts is quite powerful for engraving on materials such as wood MDF. So much so that with lower power lasers, this kind of engraving can be done. Snapmaker has thought of this too. In fact, they says, if you are actually going to do such very simple engravings, he mentions that you can make only half of the diode lasers work through the software called Luben. Thus, it reduces the power by half and reduces the laser's point fall area, and sharper results can be obtained. Talking about engraving, let's see the works I made with fabric, leather, and felt, a faux leather-covered agenda. This process was performed quickly at low power. The sharpness of the patterns and writings is nice. There is not the slightest burn or deformation point. It looks almost as successful as a work done in industrial quality. There is also a scraping process that I do on the real leather. Snapmaker Ray was able to create this pattern with very thin lines very well. In this engraving process, I turned on half of the diode laser, as in wood, and achieved very sharp results. I also cut on real leather. I specifically worked on a model in which very small parts would be cut, so people who wanted to do detailed work with this device could see what the device could and could not do. All pieces were cut beautifully. There are parts around the model maybe 0.5 mm thinner. Even this part could be cut properly without any burning. The next example is a denim fabric. Again, I chose a model with thin and mixed patterns. And as you can see, all the details are clearly visible. When you work on this type of denim fabric, the pattern appears in a yellowish tone. However, when the jeans are chemically washed in special machines, these areas become white and the patterns can then appear much more clearly. At first, when I was trying to create the pattern, I forgot to lower the power of the laser. I saw it cuts the fabric well. I said, let me try cutting it in two pieces. He did it beautifully too. It was able to cut denim quickly and cleanly. I tried cutting on felt again. Felt is a material that burns quickly in diode laser cutting. But for a fast, high-speed device with air support, such as the Snapmaker, such materials are not a problem at all. Both materials I worked on cut cleanly and precisely. While one of them can be used as a coaster, such as a drink coaster, the other can be used as a cutlery holder. When I review laser devices, I generally focus on seeing how the laser works on different materials and how it not works, rather than creating a product. But of course, from time to time, small products like this come out. These products may not be directly useful to you, but I can give you an idea. We continue to examine acrylic, which is perhaps one of the most commonly cut materials with laser devices. I cut a Harry Potter pattern in my work on 2.8 millimeter black acrylic. The most common problem in acrylic cutting is melting at sharp and thin locations on the surface. I didn't see any of these issues in my tests. Even the pointy parts at the ends of his hair, the very thin parts around his glasses and eyes, could be cut clearly without the slightest melting. Snapmaker Rail can cut most dark-colored acrylic materials. In fact, its software, Luben, has ready-made settings for cutting 8mm black acrylic. Diode lasers generally cannot cut light-colored, transparent, or mirrored acrylics, or do not give very good results. For example, I just cut a white acrylic sheet because the brand was not ambitious and I just wanted to slightly experiment. The cut could be made. The result is not bad on the circular parts of the model. However, at the points where it becomes thinner and more pointed, you can see that the material begins to melt and deform. In other words, even if it is 40 watts, the Snapmaker Ray is not a suitable device for light, white, mirrored, or transparent acrylics. The next example is an engraving I made on steel material. With a 40-watt laser, you can engrave a single color on steel, or you can engrave blue, yellow, red, and gray tones. The reason for this is that steel reacts differently to different speeds and laser power. I also use this tactic to create color on this model. What you see is the logo of the Vikings TV series. While the engraving is very clear and beautiful, it also has different tones such as blue, yellow, red, and gray. I think it is quite enjoyable to work on steel like this with a laser. For those curious about metal cutting, this is a 0.5 millimeter spring steel. I tried to cut it, but it didn't work. At first, I thought there were a lot of sparks. I think it cuts, but it is also stated on the Snapmaker website. But just because it can cut 0.1 millimeter steel. As a result, I can definitely say that the device is highly suitable for creating or engraving such a pattern on metal, but it is not very suitable for cutting. This question may come to your mind. Couldn't these operations be done with a lower power laser? Of course it could be done. Much weaker lasers can also be used, especially for engraving work. However, especially when we move on to the cutting part, the speed we can achieve with 40 watts of power is the point that makes the main difference. For example, a 2022W device can cut approximately 6 mm MDF. However, since it will have to do this more slowly, detail loss may occur at sharp edges, corners, and points. Similarly, the same goes for acrylic. Since the process will be slightly slower, melting and surface deterioration may begin. However, since the same process will be done significantly faster with a 40W laser, the results will appear much sharper and clearer. So, power, speed, and the structural integrity supporting this speed have been elevated to the top level. If you ask me, 20 watts is enough. There is also a 20-watt version of the same device. In fact, especially when working with materials like wood and MDF, you can use the cabin option with an air exhaust outlet to avoid being affected by smoke. Because some materials emit serious smell and smoke when processed, especially home users should not ignore this. And another precaution is protective glasses. Quality protective glasses are included. Never look at the laser with the naked eye while scraping or cutting, and always use your protective glasses. Overall, I like the device. I said if only these cables were a bit more organized while using it, we wouldn't have to wrap them around from the right and left of the device because it can be a bit confusing when mounting them. Other than that, everything was pretty good anyway. We all saw together how sharp and clear cuts and engravings it can make. For those who want to buy the product, I have added the link of the product in Snapmaker's website for more technical details in the description section below. I hope it was a useful video for you. See you in the next video. Goodbye.